Hey folks, I'm Jack Fossett, and welcome to this demo and review of the One Control Butter Yellow Auto Quack. This is another one designed by BJF, designed by Bjorn, and what he's doing with One Control, in my opinion, is really special. They've been putting out really high quality pedals, great enclosures, very rugged but sleek and look nice, small ones, and works great. Some of his best designs from what I've played, from his designs that have been out from other companies and things. They're really doing good work with One Control. This is the first one that I've tried that has this kind of cool new enclosure. It's sort of a matte back and sides with a textured top that looks really flashy. I love the look. Now, as far as what this is, it's an envelope filter. Now, this is something that I actually don't have a ton of experience with. Most envelope filters that I've used have been as part of modeling things, and it's not a sound that I personally gravitate towards an awful lot for my own music. However, it's really cool and it's really fun. And I think one of the things is this is one of those effects that just instantly gets you into a certain frame of mind and just kind of forces you to play differently in a good way. It really kind of opens up a new, it just makes, it's just funky. That's, when you play an envelope filter, it just makes you want to play funky. Now, this can do the wah thing very well. There's a lot of variance to it, and depending on how you set the decay and the sensitivity and how well it responds to your picking dynamics, you can do a very convincing just regular wah thing with this pedal, or you can do kind of the classic auto wah thing. There's just a lot you can do. Now, you'll notice that when I was playing, I didn't really adjust the bias that much. I kind of found a sweet spot that worked for my setup. It has a frequency range that's tailored more to the electric guitar than a lot of other envelope filters, and that makes it much more user-friendly for the guitar player. It also has this really great mellow and bright switch, just a lot of ways that you can tailor the tone so that you're not getting, you're not getting a crazy, crazy, harsh, trebly, shrill thing when you dig in, but you're also not getting too much of a swelly bass thing. There's a lot of ways you can just adjust this depending on what you're playing to make it fit pretty perfectly. And then again, with the sensitivity and decay, you can get this nice kind of long sweeping wah. You can get this sort of much punchier, kind of aggressive in a way, sort of wah sound. It's a really cool concept, and it's very simple to use, but utilizes a lot of different sounds that really suit the electric guitar a lot better than other envelope filters that you're going to find out there. Now, for this video, I was playing a PRS CE24 into a VHT D-Fifty. And again, the reason that I set it, with the bias where it was, it just kind of suited this sort of setup and everything. You kind of found that sweet spot that worked with the guitar and with the amplifier, and then went with the decay and the sensitivity from there. And I had the switch set to mellow. So that was what worked for me for this rig. Again, when I use this type of effect, for me, it's kind of like instant funky territory. That's just the place that I go with it. It's the sound that I hear. However, there are loads of other creative things that you can do with a pedal like this. So let us know in the comments if you use this and what style do you use it for. Do you use it for that classic kind of funky rhythmic style, or do you use it for something else? Also, let us know if you've used the One Control one, the new Butter Yellow Auto Quack. Again, you know, I'll sing Bjorn's praises all the time. I love his pedals. He has yet to disappoint me with one of his pedal designs that I've played. And again, the stuff, the work that I think he's doing with One Control is exceptional. So let us know your thoughts in the comments. Check out the One Control Butter Yellow Auto Quack. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.